In this video that I stumbled upon, this person was interviewing a young lady. Now, I believe the young lady is about 21 years old, but the caveat to the video is that this 21-year-old young woman has three children. Now, keep in mind, I mentioned that the interviewer, I personally feel, projects his own hurts and his own internal conflicts onto others. As he's interviewing the young lady, the young lady is very open and she also is very entertaining. She's also very, I would consider her quote unquote inspirational because she has a lot of things that she says that she appears to be using to uplift others or those who are in the range of her voice. The young lady talks about how one of her children, her daughter, receives applause and positive comments from her teachers. She talks about how one of her older children, who's about 16 or so, graduated recently. She talks about how her past was a pretty rough past, how she relocated as a young person to a tough city, how she escaped an abusive relationship by one of her children's fathers. She talks about her own relationship with her father, her biological father. She talks about her relationship with her mother. She talks about how driven she is, how much she wants to achieve, how much she wants to fulfill her life's dream, her goals. It appears that one of her goals was to become a comedic entertainer or a comedian, I think. But like I may not have mentioned, I will link the video below for you to, take a look at it and, form your own personal opinions about it. I have my own, and of course, naturally, you're obliged to have yours. Now, the reason that I was drawn to comment on this video is because there's a woman by the name of Eyanna Van Zandt. A lot of people know who she is, and then there are many people who do not know who she is. She has a TV show at this time called Fix My Life. It's very popular. It can be found on the OWN network. I think that's Oprah Winfrey's TV network. Very helpful. It's somewhat of a, I guess, coaching and part of somewhat of a spiritual coaching TV program, life coaching TV program. It oftentimes has celebrities on the show. Sometimes it doesn't, but most times it does, where Eliana coaches celebrities about their life, their goals, their troubles, etc. Eliana has many best-selling books that she has written. Eliana has been on numerous talk shows, radio shows. Was actually on The Breakfast Club. She speaks publicly. She has her own private seminars that she holds. She has spoken at the Essence Festival on a few occasions, on multiple occasions. The speeches that she gives are certainly captivating and oftentimes eye-opening for many and, certainly inspirational. Eyanna Van Zandt is connected to the other video that I would link below. Let's just say this. She had three children by the age of 21. Now, many people may not be aware of this fact. She also survived an abusive marriage that she escaped from. I think she admitted to returning to that relationship at least on one occasion. It might have been more times. She had been married multiple times and divorced, and she also admitted to have been on food stamps, on welfare. She talks about her daughter dying as a young woman from cancer and how difficult that experience was. She talked, how one day she was riding a bus or getting off of a bus, and she saw a sign about college admissions at a particular college in the city that she was in. I think she said it was up in New York. then she decided that day that she's going to go to the college, check out the courses, apply, and turn her life around. And I'm saying all of this to say that each day is a new chance to make a different choice. Each day is a new chance to make a different choice. Rihanna Van Zandt decided to make a different choice that day. And in the video with the young lady who has three children by 21, you know, I feel like the interviewer throughout the video, even though initially he appeared to have been genuinely interested in her circumstances, eventually it became obvious that he was making jest of the young woman and that, you know, he was judging her extremely harshly, despite the positive things she was saying, despite the positive outcomes that she was reporting about her children, despite the fact that she was not bashing their fathers. She didn't have their fathers on child support, which is, you know, a very controversial topic. And despite, you know, other positive things going on with the young lady, despite her escaping an abusive relationship and staying away from it and thriving past it, no, he went in on her and, you know, had nothing positive to say. I would agree that the young lady came off as a bit vulgar in her speech, but, you know, in my opinion, that's who she is. She was just being her authentic self. I'm not going to judge the way she speaks, the words she chooses to use. She was on an adult show. You know, her kids were not in the vicinity of the interview. If she chose to use profanity during the interview, the interviewer didn't seem to have a problem with it, or he didn't appear to prohibit it. I am encouraging you, my viewers today, to go and check out those two videos. I mean, when you feel like the odds are stacked against you, remember that it's just an illusion. It's just like a mirage. You know, you set goals, you achieve them one step at a time, you break them down into parts, you celebrate your achievement of the smaller parts. You know, you can have your mini celebration, whether publicly or privately, and step by step, you achieve your goals without focusing on your, you know, what happened in the past, putting yourself down because of your failures or what might happen in the future, but you had frightened yourself into imagining what might happen. You know, that creates anxiety, that creates worry, that is oftentimes unwarranted and unnecessarily once you've achieved your goal and you have triumphed, right? And you look back on it. Actually, I encourage you to check out my video, Hindsight is 2020. That's what I wanted to say today. I made a correlation with these two videos, these two interviews. Hopefully you find them also very inspirational. I ask that you share the links. And until next time, I'm going to encourage you to take care of yourself. Don't forget to check out my website. I will also leave that link. You know, you can come over there, check out my courses and other great resources you will find on my website. Till next time, bye-bye.